Hello and welcome to today's episode of Miracles of Prayers. As you may have known, Miracles of Prayer is a show, a podcast, where we showcase the importance of prayers and what prayers can do in the life of a man. All around the world, people who prayed have seen one miracle or the other. Prayer is calling the heaven to intervene in the affairs of earth. It is calling spiritual forces to help you in a time of trouble. And clearly in the Bible, we are told to pray. We are commanded to pray. Simply because God cannot do anything until a man prays. And that is why the Bible says it often and often, pray without ceasing. And so today I want to talk about the prayer of command. In the book of Job chapter 22 from verse 28, the Bible says, thou shalt decree a thing and it shall be established unto you. There is a prayer of decree. It is also called the prayer of binding and loosing. Decreeing a thing to happen in your life. Decreeing a thing to happen in your family. Decreeing a thing to happen in your work. Decreeing a thing to happen in somebody else's life. Decreeing a thing to happen in your nation is a privilege that God gave to every man. Remember, when God created man, he gave man to have dominion over the earth. In fact, the Bible says God said to man, be fruitful and multiply, replenish the earth and subdue it. So man is called to subdue the earth. And one way to subdue the earth is to pray. And that is why you cannot afford to toil with prayer. You cannot afford to neglect prayer. You cannot afford not to pray. When you don't pray, you are missing out big on a very big blessing that you could have had if you prayed. And so today I'm talking about a prayer whereby you bind and loose. A prayer whereby you decree that something should happen in your life. You decree that something should happen. Let me give you an example. When Joshua was fighting, you see, against the people of Ai, and you know, the sun was going down, it was getting dark. And Joshua knew, if this darkness can set in, these people will escape. He looked up unto God and he decreed that his son should stand still. And for 24 hours, until he finished his business, the son stood still and he did not go to night. For 24 hours, there was a stay of the movement of the earth and of the sun. And those 24 hours, Joshua was able to conquer his enemies. See, God gave you power to make a decree. He said, you shall decree a thing and it shall be established unto you. What is going on in your life? Many of the things that is happening, you need to rise and make a decree. You need to rise and make a command. Command that things go well with you. Command that you'll be healed. Command that your finances will go straight. Command that you will get a job. Command that good things will happen to your children. Command that good things will happen to your wife or your husband. Command that as you travel, you will go safely and you will come back safely. You need to make the command. If you don't make the command, nothing will happen. This is why Jesus Christ, our Lord, said to us, I give you power. Whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatsoever you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. When you refuse to bind, what you are doing is that God make his angel to garrison round about us. Your angels are redundant. When you don't bind, you are not giving them assignment. But when you bind and loose, you are engaging the angels that God put to guide you. You are engaging them to do something. When you bind, you are commanding the angels to be at work. But when you don't bind, the angels are there, but they are not given any work to do. You should engage your angels. You should maximally use your word, because you see, words are so important. Words are part of the things that change our world. You see, the Bible says God created the heavens and the earth by his word. And so words are so powerful. Words are so important. Now, without words, it's impossible. You see, without words, it's impossible to get some miracle done. You need to learn to speak your way to the peak. You see, it says, he shall have, the Bible, Jesus said in the Bible, he said, he shall have whatsoever he seeth. Mark chapter 11, verse 23. He shall have whatsoever he seeth. Now, whatsoever you say have a power to be fulfilled and to be expressed in the physical world. Words are raw materials with which God creates. Remember in the beginning, the Bible says, God said, let there be light. And there was light. You see, everything God said comes to pass. Isaiah chapter 55, the Bible says, so shall my word be that goes out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose. When God speaks word, his words come to pass because he is God. And the amazing thing about God is that he created man in his own image. We are the creature, the only creature that looks like God. We are created to be like God. In fact, in one scripture, the Bible says we are created to be the God of this world. You see? And so because we are created in the image of God and we are like God, and because we resemble God, whatsoever we say matter. We will have what we say. What we say is powerful. And so we must be careful what we say. Many times when we pray, God bless me, and we leave that place of prayer, we begin to say another thing. We begin to say, I don't know if this prayer has been answered. I really am broke. When you begin to talk like that, you negate or destroy the effect of the prayer you had prayed earlier on. When you say things contrary to the prayer you prayed, you destroy the power and the effect of that prayer. Many times we say to ourselves that we prayed and prayed and we have not received answers to our prayer, not knowing that through our words we have destroyed the effect of the prayers we prayed earlier. You must be careful that every word you speak is a seed. Every word you speak is a command. Every word you speak is a decree. And so you must watch it when you speak. Whenever you pray that God should do something, when you leave that place of prayer, you must continue to speak as if God have answered you. Because this is the principle of answered prayer. The principle is found in Mark chapter 11, verse 24. And it says, therefore I say unto you, whatsoever things you desire, when you pray, believe that you have received them, and you shall have them. You see, when you pray, you must believe that you already have the things that you ask God. You must believe that you already have it. And the Bible says, and you shall have it. You must believe you already have it before you have it. You see, in the world, there's a slogan, seeing is believing. I can't believe it until I see it. That's the principle of the world. But you see, in Christ, the opposite is the case. In Christ, believing is seeing. Believing comes before seeing what you are believing. If you are believing for healing, you must, if you want healing, you must believe that God has healed you when your body is still aching before you have the healing. So when you decree something, you must believe that all the decrees you made, all those decrees has been established. And those decrees must be seen physically. It must manifest. Why? Because you believe it. When you believe it, you will have it. This is the principle. This is what our Lord Jesus Christ told us. And this is what he taught us. And when you look at the teachings of Jesus, this teaching of faith is very paramount, is very important. And this is where I'm going to stop. Thank you for listening to this podcast this morning. Please rebroadcast this to your friends in Twitter, on Facebook, on LinkedIn, everywhere. Rebroadcast this. Get somebody praying. People need to pray. This is a time for prayer. And I know God will bless you. Thank you so much for listening to this podcast. Please come back again tomorrow and be blessed through this podcast. This is your brother, your friend, your pastor, the pastor of Prevailing Church of Christ, Springs Town, Johannesburg, South Africa, signing out this morning and saying to you, be blessed and remain blessed.